Hi everyone, it's me Indra. Welcome back to my channel. Today in this video I am going to discuss about the concept of the derivative of a function. The derivative, it is the new topic here. The derivative has the so many applications. We can evaluate the maximum and the minimum value of any functions by using the derivative, as well as the derivative is used to calculate the rate of change of one variable with respect to another. We can use the derivative, the concept of the derivative, to find the slope of a any curve at a particular point. There are so many applications of the derivative. We will discuss about the applications of the derivative in our next video. Here we are going to define what is the derivative of a function. Please watch this video till the end so that you will be very clear about the concept, basic concept of the derivative of a function. Without wasting any further time, let's get started. Here today's topic is derivative of a function. Let's take a function y is equals to f of x. Here the function y is equals to f of x is taken here, where the x is the input and the y is the output variable, and it is defined. The function f of x is continuous. First of all, let's say it is continuous. It is continuous in an open interval I. Here a function f of x is continuous in an open interval I. Then at this situation, let's suppose the delta x, read as delta x is the small increment. It is an increment in the variable x. It is an small increment. Here we have taken a function y is equals to f of x. It is continuous in an open interval I, and here we define the delta x as the small increment in the variable y. Similarly, delta y, it is an small increment in the variable y. Let's write here. It is a small increment in the variable y. Here a function f of x is taken continuous in an open interval I, and the delta x and the delta y are the small increments in x and y respectively. Then the definition of the derivative of a function, this function f of x, is defined. The derivative, then derivative of the function, here the function is f of x, the derivative of a function f of x is, let's first write its notation. It is denoted by, the derivative of a function f of x is denoted by, there are so many ways to denote the derivative of a function, that it is denoted by, let's take the first representation, first notation. It is denoted by dy over dx. It is the one notation for representing the derivative of a function y is equals to f of x. Dy by dx, or it can be denoted by the another symbol like this, f dash of x. It is the another way to denote the derivative of a function f of x. And similarly, we can write, or it is also denoted d by dx. Here I am going to take the derivative of this function with respect to x. So d by dx of the function, here the function is taken f of x. it is the another way to denote the derivative of a function, or simply another next way is, or simply y dash. There are how many notation here? One notation, dy by dx, it is the derivative of a function y with respect to x. Or we can write like this, f dash of x, or we can use this notation, or we can just write y dash. This notation represents the derivative of a function y is equals to f of x. It is the notation, and these are the notation for the derivative of a function y is equals to f of x, and it is defined as the limiting value of the derivative. The concept of the derivative is totally related with the concept of the limit and continuity. We already discussed about the topic limit and continuity. Here, let's discuss about the derivative. And it is defined as the limiting. Defined as a limiting value of when the limit, the delta x, it is the input, delta x is small increment in the input tends to 0, limit when delta x tends to 0 of the function delta y over delta x. It is the basic definition of the derivative of a function. Limit of the function delta y over delta x when the delta x approaches to 0. This is the definition of the derivative of a function. But here the limit should be exist. Provided that the limit exists. To calculate the derivative of any functions, the functions should be continuous. It should be continuous, and the limit should be exist. And we already know that the continuous functions has the limiting value, has any finite limiting value, provided that the limit exists. This is the definition of the derivative of a function y is equals to f of x. So we can conclude here the derivative of a function is a, here the, let's use this symbol d of a function. Dy by dx, it is read as derivative of y with respect to x. It is read as derivative of y with respect to the variable x. Here the denominator variable is x, so with respect to x, it is read as, and it is defined here the limit delta x approaches to 0, it has the very closer value as a 0. It approaches to 0 of the function delta y over delta x. It is the limiting value, just limiting value of these functions when the delta x approaches to 0. This is the definition, this is the basic way to calculate the derivative of a function, and this method to calculate the derivative of a function called as the first principle method. It is the very fundamental way to calculate the derivative of any function. And let's take here, let's derive the some formula for calculating the derivative of a function. Here the function, let me write here, the function is here, y is equals to f of x. This is the function which is defined in an open interval I. It is the continuous also. And let's increment the both the variable y and x to very small amount. Let's increment the variable x by delta x and the variable y by delta y. After incrementing, let's incrementing, let's write here incrementing y by delta y and x by delta x. After incrementing, our equations will be y plus some increment 1 in delta y is equals to f of, here the x is going to be increment, x plus delta x. After incrementing, we have this relation. Let me write here, after this, or here from this equations we can evaluate the value of the delta y as a, by transposing this y to the right hand side, f of x plus delta x minus this y. And the, this can further written as f of x plus delta x, and the y is here f of x minus f of x. Here we obtain the value of the delta y is equals to here f of x plus delta x minus f of x from this relation. Let's divide these equations by the delta x on the both side, and it approaches to zero. Let's divide, after dividing these equations by delta x on the both side, we will get the value of the f delta y over delta x is a f of x plus delta x minus f of x over delta x. Here we just divide both side of these equations by delta x. The let's take the limit of delta x approaches to zero on the both side. After taking the limit, limit delta x, let's write here limit delta x approaches to zero, then the value of the delta y over delta x, it is just the definitions of the derivative of a functions, derivative of functions dy by dx. And it will be after inserting the limiting value on the both side, we will get the limit delta x approaches to zero of the function f of x plus delta x minus fx over this delta x. Here we just insert the limit x tends to zero on the both side of these equations, and then we finally obtain this relations for calculating the derivative of a function y is equals to f of x. This is the formula for calculating the derivative of a function. Here we finally obtain an equations for calculating the derivative of a function y is equals to f of x. And this quantity, when the delta x approaches to zero of the function delta y by delta x, it is called as, this relation called as the instantaneous rate of change of variable y with respect to s. It is also called as instantaneous rate of change of y, rate of change of y with respect to the variable x. This symbol, this quantity, this whole quantity also called as the instantaneous rate of change of the variable y with respect to x.